الحي الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. Tijarin.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Let's continue the takbir inshallah. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Walillahil hamd. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Walillahil hamd. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد
Assalamu alaikum. We'll get started in a few minutes. Just a few things. One is, you know, of course, Eid al-Adha. Takbir is loud, coming and going. It is sunnah when you come for Eid Salat to go come from one direction, and when you go back, go a different way. The takbir in this Eid, you know, started yesterday after Fajr, and will continue on until Asr on Friday. So after every Salat, you know, you should say, after every Fard Salat, you say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Wa lillahi alhamd. At least once, preferably three times. If you don't know all of that, then at least Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. But, you know, so after every first salat, the first thing you do when you make salam, do the takbir. Loud. Yeah. For the men, loud. For the women, of course, low. Animals for sacrifice, of course, you know, goats, sheep, cow, camel. Of course, there are no camels here. Goats need to be at least 1 year old. Sheep, so long as they look big, can be 6 months old or older. Cows have to be at least 2 years old. So camels would be 5 years old if we had any around here. But so, you know, these things are emphasized, and you know, these are things that we should do. There is a narration in which it's said that, that on this day of Eid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't love anything more than the blood that's dripping from the blade after the slaughter. It's encouraged because this is not, you know, this is, the reality of it is the sacrifice of the self, of the nafs. Even though, you know, we're sacrificing an animal, but we, when we're, the dua that we're making as we're sacrificing that animal is that, oh Allah, accept this in lieu of ourselves. You know, it's hair for our hair, it's blood for our blood, it's flesh for our flesh. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so generous, He lets us off so easy. Even though this Eid points us towards another sacrifice, which is the sacrifice of the household of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is the only reason that Islam still exists today. Otherwise, there would be no Islam and there would be no world. You know, because when the last moment dies, everything is destroyed. So we will, inshallah, get started. Each salat is 2 rakat. Here, according to Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi, the methodology of Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi, 6 additional takbirat. 3 in the first rakat and 3 in the second rakat. The 3 in the first rakat will be before Surah Fatiha. So we'll say, Imam will say Allahu Akbar, everybody will complete their intention and say Allahu Akbar. And after Thana, Subhanakallahumma, then there will be 3 additional takbirs. Allahu Akbar, don't tie your hands, Allahu Akbar. And again, Allahu Akbar, and then you tie your hands, and then Surah Fatiha and Surah. In the second rakat, the 3 additional takbir are before the ruku, after the surah. So the imam will recite Surah Fatiha, recite a surah, and then before going into ruku, Allahu Akbar. So everybody raises their hands and then leaves them. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. The 4th takbir is for the ruku. So the 3 additional, and then the 4th is for the ruku. And then salat will be completed as usual. The khutbah, of course, for Eid is after salat. 2 khutbah, you know, khutbatain, as usual. Inshallah, won't take too long. Because Eid al-Adha is Eid al-Adha, because Adha is the time of mourning in which everything is bright, but the sun is still not very hot, so it's still cool. So it's Adha because that's when we sacrifice, or that's when it's preferred to sacrifice, before it gets really hot. Of course, the days of sacrifice are 3, today, tomorrow, and Wednesday until Maghrib. Thursday until Maghrib, tomorrow is Wednesday. So these 3 days are the days of sacrifice, inshallah. Any questions? I think everything's clear. So, and there's no adhan and there's no iqama for this salat. So we'll
make our rows. And
we'll make our rows, and then make intention, and the salat will start, inshallah. So everybody, just line up, inshallah. Try to shift to the left so that other people coming can get in. To your right, my left. Everybody good? Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى فنيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تسلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارك مسفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نسبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن علينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله المتوحد بعظمته والجلال، المتقدس بحسن والجمال، هو الذي خالق لجميع الشيء والأمر، بيده مفاتيح الدهر، فتبارك الله رب العالمين. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. الله أكبر ولله الحمد. سبحان من أوجب صلاة العيد على كافة المؤمنين، وحرم عليهم الصوم في أيام خمسة يوم عيد الأضحية وثلاثة أيام بعده متتاليات، والخامس يوم الفطر ضيافة من عنده للمسلمين والمسلمات. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. الله أكبر ولله الحمد. سبحان من سبحت له السماوات السبع والأرضون السبع والأرش العظيم والكعبة الحسناء والركن والحتيم والزمزم ومقام إبراهيم. تعالى الله ذو الجلال والإكرام، وتبارك الله الملك القدوس السلام. سبحان من تقدس ذاته عن التشبيه والتمثيل. سبحان من تنزه صفاته عن التغيير والتبديل، وتكفل بأرزاق العباد لأنه للملك المعبود. وعهدنا إلى إبراهيم وإسماعيل أن طهر بيتي للطائفين والعاكفين والركع السجود. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم. أوصيكم أيها الناس، اعلموا أن الله تعالى فردا عليكم الحج بشرط استطاعة، وأوجب الأضحية لطفا وكرامة، فاجعلوها براقا ومضية ومذية ليوم الحسرة والندامة. روي عن زيد بن عرقم رضي الله تعالى عنه قال: أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم: ما هذه الأداهي يا رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم؟ قال: سنة أبيكم إبراهيم. قالوا: فما لنا فيها يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم؟ قال يكل شعرة حسرة سمنودها ياكم، فإنها على النسرة متى ياكم، ولا تذبحوا أجفاء ولا عرجاء ولا عوراء ولا مقطوعة الأذن ولو بواحدة، فعن كل واحدة منكم شهر. سواء كانت ذكر أو أنثى أو سبع البقرة أو الإبل. وكبروا عقيب الصلاة المفروضة من فجر عرفة إلى عصر أيام التشريق. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وإذ يرفع إبراهيم قواعد من البيت وإسماعيل ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. Today, of course, is the day of Eid. And again, Eid is a day that comes over and over. It is something that is looked for, or something that you look forward to all year long. And the story of this Eid, Eid al-Adha, is something that is repeated again and again. And even though the story or the incident stays the same, the lessons that we learn from it, our understanding of it, and our application of those lessons is what should be continuously growing and increasing. We all know the story of Ibrahim alayhis salam, his selflessness, his sacrifice, his complete submission to his Lord. And this is part of what this Eid is reminding us. This Eid is connected to the Hajj, and if we look at the arkan or the obligations of the Hajj, the vast majority of them are connected with Ibrahim al-Islam or his family. When we look at the obligations of Islam, the pillars of Islam, we know that they are five, beginning with Iman or with faith in La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that we testify that there is no one worthy of worship but Allah, and that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his messenger. And then after that, of course, is salat, then zakat, fasting in Ramadan, and then the final pillar is hajj. These pillars are not equal. They are the foundations of the religion. And the foundation of all of them is Iman. They are built on top of one another. So if there is no Iman, then none of the others matter. Hajj can be looked at as the roof of this house. It is the zenith or the pinnacle of the obligations of Islam. When we look at this, however, we see that every aspect of the Hajj is connected to and reminds us of the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. Those that love Allah and those that are loved by Allah. So when we go for the Hajj, or when we think about the Hajj, the first thing we think about is the Kaaba, and doing tawaf around the Kaaba. And when we think about that, we remember Ibrahim al-Islam along with Ismail al-Islam building the Kaaba. And then right after that, the supplication that they made, which is mentioned in the Quran, where they say, where the verse starts off with Rabbana wa qabath fihim rasula, where they ask Allah, O our Lord, go ahead and send that messenger. And then they specify which messenger. The one who will be sent with the book and the wisdom. And the cleanliness of the heart. So they asked for whom? They asked for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then afterwards we think about Zamzam, and we think about the sa'i between Safa and Marwa, where their mother of Ismail al-Islam is running, because her child is thirsty. And not just any child, but this child is a prophet. And not just any prophet. This prophet contains within him the nur of Rasulullah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is to be passed down through the generations, and then to be manifest as Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When we think about Mina, we think about the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhi salam. We think about his rejection of Shaitan and the suggestions of Shaitan. You know, when Shaitan came to him in the form of an old man and tried to reason with him, tried to rationalize with him, that why are you going to sacrifice your son? And Ibrahim al-Islam's rejection of that over the command of his Lord. And here we not only remember the submission of Ibrahim al-Islam, but also the submission of Ismail al-Islam. When his father says to him, I have seen in my vision that I sacrifice you. And he says to him what? He says to his father, do as you are commanded. And if Allah wills, you will find me among those who are patient. And then we remember Arafat, which in itself means to recognize over and over. And when we look at Arafat, we don't find any connection with Ibrahim al-Islam. So when we look harder, we find Jabal al-Rahmah, the Mountain of Mercy. And then we are reminded that Jabal al-Rahmah, or the Mountain of Mercy, is named the Mountain of Mercy because this is where Adam al-Islam's repentance was accepted. When he ate from the tree, the shajara, when he and his wife ate from the shajara or from the tree, and they are expelled from Jannah. And while in Jannah, as soon as they are asked, they say, رَبَّنَا ذَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَا مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. O our Lord, we have truly wronged our own souls. And if you are not merciful and forgiving, we will be destroyed. And yet they are still expelled from Jannah. And for 300 years, he makes this supplication over and over again, and no response. Until finally they meet each other in Arafat, and they recognize each other. But above that, they recognize what they have forgotten, why their repentance was not accepted. And now when he makes this same dua, with the wasila of Rasulullah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts his dua. Every aspect of worship in Islam, we worship Allah, but every aspect of worship of Allah is connected to the ones that Allah loves. Even when we make salat, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said what? He said, make salat as you see me making salat. He did not say, make salat as I make salat. Because that's an impossibility for us. He said, make it as you see me making it. So even when we're making salat, there is no salat without the remembrance of Rasulullah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because when we stand, we remember that we stand like this because he stood like this. When we bow down, we bow or make a ruku like this because he made a ruku like this. And when we make sajda, we remember that we make sajda like this because he made sajda like this. But again, Hajj is even a more open reminder of this point, that every aspect of worship in Islam is connected to the ones Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, because they are truly his signs. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, he refers to Safa and Marwa as his signs, because they remind us of Bibi Hajra, the mother of Ismail alayhi salam, and her running, which in turn reminds us of Ismail al-Islam, and then we make that connection with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the only true sign of Allah, or rather the greatest sign of Allah, even though everything in creation is His sign, but the greatest sign of Allah is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself. That when we see Him, when we remember Him, and when we remember His perfection and His beauty, we are reminded of the greatness of His Lord, His Creator. When we remember the Kaaba, we are reminded of Ibrahim al-Islam and Ismail al-Islam and their dedication to their Lord and their prayer that, oh Allah, go ahead and send this messenger that you have promised, who again reminds us of our Lord. There is no worship in Islam, there is no ibadah in Islam without remembering the ones Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. And when we look at the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he is sacrificing his son, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaces it with a ram, and he says, وَتَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ فِي الْآخِرِينَ, I have postponed this sacrifice for later generations. And the only one who fits that is the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Imam Hussein al-Islam, in the field of Karbala, when he sacrificed his whole household and himself to safeguard the religion that his grandfather had brought. And we're living in a time of fitna, turmoil and tribulations and trials. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us that before the last day, the Hajj and the Umrah will be abandoned. And we see this happening before us. Now, if somebody wants to argue that no, at least some people are making the Hajj or the Umrah, this is at least a situation to get our minds ready for that coming, to desensitize us to this. It's interesting that even though there are limitations placed upon who can come for the Hajj, and while they are limiting the Hajj and the Umrah, or rather restricting it severely, at the same time they are building 200 more new cinemas and other gathering halls, and having concerts, and having half-naked models come and do photo shoots. Because the only place you can get corona is in the masjid. Nothing else is restricted, except when it comes to the obligations of Islam. Events are either manufactured, and those that aren't manufactured are manipulated, and even the ones that are manufactured are manipulated. And we see this fitna and this manipulation going on, and we can't realize it. This is the biggest fitna. And this is why Rasulullah ﷺ, he taught us to seek refuge from the fitna of Dajjal. Because things that used to be hidden now are done openly. And yet we still don't recognize them.
because we've been so desensitized to all of these things, that they don't compute. And the reason that the desensitization has been successful is because we have gone away from the Messenger of Allah. There is no way to get close to Allah except through the Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And if we have separated ourselves from Him, if we have started thinking about Him just like anybody else, thinking about Him as somebody who simply brought a message, and now I can do what with the message whatever I wish. When we have lost that connection, then everything in our lives has no meaning. Everything that we see before us, Rasulullah ﷺ has already taught us and told us these things in detail. Not like others, not like soothsayers or other people who tell you vague things in vagueality so you can interpret them however you wish. He has told us everything we see before us in detail. And yet we choose to ignore them. Because again, we have lost that connection with Him. And until we reestablish that connection, then we will drown in this world. As He has told us, when this time of fitna comes, He said, make the prayer of a drowning man. Because we are drowning in the fitna, in all of these tests and tribulations. And we are going through them without recognizing them. If we can't recognize them, then how will we defend ourselves against them? And the main point again, and I'll end with this, is that the only way to safeguard ourselves is to reestablish our connection with the Messenger of Allah, with the Rasulullah. With our hearts. If our hearts are connected, because the Ummah is one body. This Ummah is one body. And the reality of that body is the Rasulullah himself. And if we do not join within that body, then we are lost. And because we are lost, we don't feel for those who are suffering today. And one of the lessons we get from this Eid is to pay attention to those who are suffering. And we see what is going on in the world, whether it's in Palestine, and they are raiding the Masjid al-Aqsa as we speak, or whether it's in Kashmir. And at least those two places are being tormented by the non-believers, or those who claim to have no belief or no faith. What can we say about Yemen? Those who are supposed to be the safeguard guardians of the two holy shrines, constantly bombing them and killing the women and children. We see what's happening in Sham. You know, I could name every Muslim country. And yet our eyes are closed. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to reconnect with His Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who not only is the Messenger, but in reality is the Message Himself. And may He make us understand the maqam, the status, and the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhis salam, so that we can safeguard ourselves from the fitna of this time, which is in reality the fitna of Dajjal.
بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ورفعنا وإياكم للآيات وذكر الحكيم أستغفر الله لي ولكم أجمعين إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعد من صلى وسام. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعد من قعد وقام وصلى الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين وصلى الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. والملائكة المقربين والخلفاء الراشدين خصوصا على خير البشر بعد الأنبياء بالتحقيق أمير المؤمنين أبي بكر الصديق رضي الله تعالى عنه وعلى مزين المنبر والمحراب أمير المؤمنين عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه وعلى كامل الحياء والإيمان أمير المؤمنين عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه وعلى مظهر العجائب والغرائب أمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب كرم الله وجه وعلى الإمامين الحمامين السيدين الشهيدين أبي محمد الحسن وأبي عبد الله الحسين رضي الله تعالى عنهما وعلى أمهما سيدة النساء فاطمة الزهراء رضي الله تعالى عنها وعلى عميه المكرمين بين الناس أبي عمارة الحمزة وأبي فضل العباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما وعلى الستة الباقية من الأشرة المبشرة وسائر المهاجرين والأنصار والتابعين الأبرار الأخيار إلى يوم القرار ورضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. اللهم اغفر لي ولوالدي ولجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات إنك سميع مجيب الدعوات. اللهم أيد المسلمين بالإمام العادل والخير والتعال واتبع سنن سيد الموجودات. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم. عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يعمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولا ذكر الله تعالى عالى وأولى وعز وجل وهم وتم وأكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. عيد مبارك.